We want to solve the given radical equation that contains two radicals. To do this, we want to first put one radical on each side of the equation, then raise both sides of the equation to the power of the index. Once we do this, we'll simplify, and if the equation still contains a radical, we'll isolate the radical on one side of the equation and raise both sides to the power of the index again, then simplify and solve the resulting equation and check our solution or solutions. So looking at our equation again, notice how we have a square root on each side of the equation. So the next step is going to be to square both sides of the equation. So we'll square this. And then we're going to square the entire right side. We cannot just square each term. So on the left side, when we square the square root of 2x plus 6, this simplifies nicely to 2x plus 6. But on the right, we actually have to write this out and multiply. So we're going to have the square root of x plus 4 plus 1 times the square root of x plus 4 plus 1. And when multiplying this, we're going to have four products, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So we'll have 2x plus 6 equals the square root of x plus 4 times the square root of x plus 4 will just be x plus 4. Next, we have the square root of x plus 4 times 1, which is equal to the square root of x plus 4. And notice this third product will also be the square root of x plus 4. So we have plus 2 times the square root of x plus 4, and then 1 times 1 is equal to 1. So we've made some progress, but now we still have one square root to deal with. So now we're going to isolate this square root and then square both sides again. But before we do this, let's go ahead and simplify the right side. We have 2x plus 6 equals, we have x plus 4 plus 1 would be 5, so 5 plus 2 times the square root of x plus 4. Be careful not to add this 4 and 2 because this 2 is attached by multiplication. And now to start isolating the square root, let's go ahead and subtract x on both sides, as well as subtract 5 on both sides. So we'll have x, this will be plus 1, equals, this is 0, this is 0. So we have 2 times the square root of x plus 4. Let's go ahead and finish this up here. So we have the quantity x plus 1 equals 2 times the square root of x plus 4. Now we'll divide both sides by 2. So we have x plus 1 divided by 2 equals the square root of x plus 4. Now to undo this square root, we have to square both sides again. So on the right side, we're going to have the quantity x plus 1 times the quantity x plus 1 all over 2 squared would be 4. This is going to be equal to x plus 4. Let's go ahead and multiply out the numerator. We have x squared plus x plus x, that's plus 2x, and then plus 1. So we have x squared plus 2x plus 1 all over 4 equals x plus 4. Let's finish this on the next slide. Looking at the left side here, because we're dividing by a monomial, we can divide each term by 4, so we can write this as 1 4th x squared plus 2x over 4, that would be plus 1 half x, plus 1 over 4, 1 4th, equals x plus 4. Now because we have a quadratic, we're going to set this equal to 0 and see if we can factor. So to set it equal to 0, we'll subtract x on both sides and subtract 4 on both sides. Notice on the right side, this would be 0 and this would be 0. On the left side, we have 1 4th x squared, and then 1 half x minus 1 x would be negative 1 half x or minus 1 half x. And then for 1 4th minus 4, common denominator would be 4, so we'd have 1 minus 16 in the numerator and 4 in the denominator, that's going to be minus 15 fourths. And now to see if this is going to factor, we want to clear these fractions, so we're going to multiply both sides of the equation by 4. So we'll have x squared minus 2x minus 15 equals 0. Looks like this will factor. The first factors will be the factors of x squared, which would be x and x. And now we want the factors of negative 15 that add to negative 2. Well, negative 5 times 3 is equal to negative 15, and negative 5 plus 3 is equal to negative 2. So that means one of the factors will be x minus 5, and one factor will be x plus 3. So this product is equal to 0 when x minus 5 is equal to 0, or x equals 5, or when x plus 3 equals 0, or when x equals negative 3. So algebraically, it appears we have two solutions, but we do have to check these to make sure they actually work. So when x equals 5, looking at our equation, we'd have the square root of 2 times 5, that's 10, plus 6, that's the square root of 16, equals the square root of, this would be the square root of 5 plus 4, the square root of 9 plus 1. So we have 4 equals 3 plus 1, that's true. So x equals 5 is the solution. Now let's check x equals negative 3. When x equals negative 3 on the left, we'd have the square root of negative 6 plus 6, that's going to be the square root of 0, equals, and on the right side, we'd have the square root of negative 3 plus 4, that's the square root of 1 plus 1. Well, 0 does not equal the square root of 1 plus 1, or 1 plus 1, which would be 2. So x equals negative 3 is what we call an extraneous solution and is not a solution. We only have one solution, it's x equals 5. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.